الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. Last lesson in our شرح of علوم القرآن, the science of Quran. I mentioned the last point, remember? The objectives that I want to achieve from this module or this course. What did I say? What was the objectives and the aims that I had? I mentioned three. Does anyone have their notes? Huh? Beautiful. Okay. Can somebody else say it loudly as well? This side, I want this side. Huh? Wait. Nah. When I was talking about the aims and the objectives that I want to achieve from this course, inshallah ta'ala, al-madkhal to ulum al-Qur'an, what did I mention? Yeah? My aim and objective is three things. Remember I said three things. Number one was what? At-ta'arruf ala al-ulum, to define terms. That we're going to give a lot of importance to definitions and knowing the meanings of words. Didn't we say that? So inshallah ta'ala, we're still in that part. Today we're going to define revelation. So today we're going to define the following. Today's class is going to be on these four points, inshallah ta'ala. We're going to do ta'arif al-wahi, inshallah ta'ala. We're going to define what revelation is. We're going to speak about its types. Inshallah ta'ala. We're going to speak about the way that the revelation used to come down. And inshallah ta'ala, we're going to we're also going to refute the doubts that have been brought regarding the revelation of the Quran. Today's class is going to be these four points, inshallah ta'ala. When you leave, you should know the answer and you should have an understanding to these four points. Number one is ta'arif al-wahi. What does wahi mean? What does wahi mean? What's the revelation? Second is the aqsam, the revelation, how much is it categorized into? What are its types? The third one is kayfiyatuh, its way. How did the revelation used to come down on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? And the fourth one is وَالرَّدِّ الشُّبَهِ الَّتِي أُثُورَتْ حَوْلَى. We're going to refute the doubts that have been brought regarding the wahi, the revelation. Number one, we're going to define the revelation. تَعْرِفُهُ الْوَحِي. We're going to define the revelation. We're going to speak about the types of revelation there are. Are we all together? Number three is how the revelation used to come down. We'll speak about that inshallah ta'ala. And the fourth one is, if we get time, this is nafilatul qawl. It's not the zubda and it's not the sulb al-mawdu', but we'll try to respond to some of the doubts that have been brought regarding the revelation of the Quran. Okay. أثيرت حوله, that's been spread regarding it. What does the word وحي mean? Again, we're going to define it in the لغة and we're going to define it اصطلاحا. Again, we always do that. What does revelation lughatan mean? And what does it mean? Istilahan. The word wahi, revelation in the Arabic language in which the Quran used it in. The Quran used it sometimes, the word al-wahi, in the linguistic meaning. And it is three, inshallah ta'ala, three usages does that language have. The Quran used it. And this is the linguistic one, not the technical one. The Quran used the linguistic one and he also used the technical one. The first one is al-ilham al-fitri. Al-ilham. So I'm just going to write this one, okay, here. Al-ilham al-fitri. We'll explain what that means, inshallah ta'ala. Al-ilham al-fitri. The second one is al-ilham al-ghariziyu. Third one is al-isharatu al-sari'a. All three of those Quran used it. You guys are going to have to help me here with the translation in English, inshallah ta'ala, so work together. Al-ilham means to be given what? The understanding of something. What would be the best definition for the word ilham in the English language? Huh? Inspiration? Any other word? Huh? Inspiration, huh? Any other word? Okay, let's use that. That's the only word I could also think of. Ilham al-fitri means innate inspiration. Like in Shaykh al-Islam in the Kitab al-Nubuwat, he mentions that the ilham al-fitri is the one that's given to the person. Ilham al-fitri is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inspires a person innately to do something. It's an innate thing. It's something that's natural. As Allah said in the Quran, وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَىٰ أُمِّ مُوسَىٰ أَنْ أَرْضِعِهِ وَأَوْحَيْنَا was sent on the mother of what? Musa. Meaning Allah is saying, we gave Musa's mother the innate ability that is in every mother to breastfeed her child. Isn't that something that's in every mother? Huh? Does that make sense? Look what Allah said, وَأَوْحَيْنَا. وَأَوْحَيْنَا is wahi. إِلَىٰ أُمِّ مُوسَىٰ أَنْ أَرْضِعِهِ. Allah says, we gave ilham fitri to the mother of Musa to do what? That doesn't mean revelation is coming down on the mother of Musa, because revelation does not come on any woman. Sahih? Shaykh al-Islam says this is ijma'. Even though Ibn Hazm went against it, like it's ijma', that it doesn't come down on what? Woman. So, وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَىٰ أُمِّ مُوسَىٰ. Ha, intuition, na'am, sahih. Allah gave Musa's mother the understanding to breastfeed her child. She did that. So this is ilham fitri. The difference between ilham fitri and ilham gharizi is for the haywan, is for the animal. It's the innate ability that's given to the animal. This is given to the human, and this is given to the animal, and it's the one Allah says, وَأَوْحَى رَبُّكَ إِلَى النَّحْلِ. وَأَوْحَى رَبُّكَ إِلَى النَّحْلِ. Allah sent down, he gave ilham gharizi to the bee. Allah used the word wahi for the bee here. That's the second usage. The third one is al-isharat al-sari'a. Specifically, when it's done on the hand. When somebody does a gesture on his hand, as Allah said in the ayah, فَخَرَجَ. Allah says, فَقَرَجَ عَلَىٰ قَوْمٍ مِنَ الْمِحْرَابِ فَأُوحَىٰ إِلَيْهِمْ أَنْ سَبِّحُوهُ. فَأُوحَىٰ هِيَ مِنْ أَيْ وَأَشَارَ سَرِيعًا. To use your hand and gesture to somebody quickly. Allah used it as the word wahi. Are we all together? To use a... Which one? Number one and number two are the same. The difference between the two is, the first one is for the humans, and the second is what? For the haywan. The bee is a haywan, right? Does that make sense? The third one is al-ishara. Ishara is to what? It's to gesture, right? Allah says, فخرج على قومه. She came out on her people. He came out. Nabila Zakaria came out on his people, and what did he do? فأوحى إليهم أي فأشار إليهم. He gestured to them and سبحوه, to exalt him سبحانه وتعالى. It's in Surah Maryam, صح؟ It's in Ayah Surah Maryam. These are all the linguistic usage. This doesn't mean that the wahi that we're talking about today, the wahi that we're talking about, none of these are wahi. The one that comes down on a bee, or the one that comes down on the mother of Nabiullah Musa, or the one that's a gesture, that's not what we're talking about. We're going to go into the istilahi one. But istilahi one is what? There's so many definitions. Each definition, there's a... So I'm just going to take the easiest one for you now. Are we all together, brothers? Even if it's not a comprehensive definition, don't worry about it. As time goes on, we'll start working on finding the best definition, inshallah ta'ala, together. Like in the easiest one for you now is the one that Ibn al-Qayyim mentions, rahimahullah, which is, huwa kalamullah istilahan. I'm going to rub this off now. Istilahan. What does wahi mean? It means kalamullah, the speech of Allah. Number one. Al-munazzal, that was sent down, ala nabiyyin min anbiya'ihi. It's sent on a prophet from the prophets of Allah. So it's three things. It first of all, kalamullahi. Kalamullahi. It's the speech of Allah. Second is what? Al-munazzal. It's sent down. Three. Who is it sent down? Nabi min to a prophet from his prophets. Does that make sense? That's a wahi. Istilahan. When we say kalamullah, when we say the speech of Allah, what enters there? Yeah? The Quran and the Sunnah. We will take the Sunnah in there as well. Is the Sunnah not the speech of Allah Azza wa Jalla? It is. Sunnah is the speech of Allah min حيث المعنى لا من حيث اللفظ. The meaning is Allah's kalam, subhanAllah. The meaning is the speech of Allah Azza wa Jalla, not in terms of wording. And we don't want to go too much into that now and confuse you all. But it's the speech of Allah. Al-Munazzal, that was sent down on a prophet from the prophets. So everything that was sent down to Nabiullah Adam, to Nabiullah Muhammad, all of it is called a wahy. It's called a wahy. So it's kalamullah, the speech of Allah. Al-Munazzal, that was sent down, and it was sent down to a prophet from the prophets. So, alhamdulillah, we've defined wahy lughatan wa istilahan. Technically, linguistically, we defined it, and technically, we have defined it. True or false? Yeah? Sahih? We did, right? Good. Now I'm going to move on to its types. Hey, have I defined it? Its types is what? It's two. The aqsamuhu is what? It's two. And I already gave it to you, alhamdulillah. It's the lugha and the thing that came out of it. And the third one, which is istilahan, if you want to call it, and ash-shar'an, if you want to call it. Are we together? The types are what? Lugha and ash-shar'a. That's number one. And that's number two. Those are the two types of revelations. The linguistic type of the linguistic one, and the what? And the technical one. Those are the two types of revelation. Are we all together? Does everyone understand that? Okay, now we're going to go into the third one, which is وكيفياته. how the revelation used to come down. The revelation, the way that it used to come down is four ways. As Imam al-Baghawi mentioned, rahimahullah, when it came to the ayah, وَمَا كَانَ لِبَشَرٍ أَن يُكَلِّمَهُ اللَّهِ, when it came to that ayah, Imam al-Baghawi, we're going to mention them, he mentions that the revelation, the way that it used to come down is four. How did the revelation come down? Four ways. The first one is, مَا يَكُونُ مَنَامًا, that which used to be a sleep, was a dream. The second one is, مَا يَكُونُ إِلْهَامًا. This ilham, don't confuse it with the ilham al-fitri, ama the ilham al-gharizi. No, this is ilham shar'i. Okay, it's not ilham lughawi. The third one is, don't worry, we'll touch on each one. مَا يَكُونُ ما يكون مكالمة بين الرب والعبد. ما يكون. The fourth one is ما يكون بواسطة أمين السماء. Pay attention here, inshallah ta'ala, then you can write it. The ways that he used to come down is four. مَا يَكُونُ مَنَامًا, it will be a dream. This prophet will be sleeping and it will come down to him as a dream. That's one. مَا يَكُونُ إِلْحَامًا, that which was an ilham, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will guide the prophet to do this. He will inspire the prophet to do this. This is a shar'i one. It's not fitri to everybody. It's not ghareezi, which is lughawi. This is shar'i. Meaning, the ilham that the Prophet gets, it's something that the people have to do. Does that make sense? Number four, ما يكون مكالمة. The Prophet will actually be speaking to بين الرب والعبد. Allah will be talking to the Prophet and the Prophet will be talking to Allah and will be taking directly from what? Allah Azza wa Jalla. The fourth one is ما يكون بواسطة أمين السماء. Jibreel will come down on what? Huh? Jibreel will come down to the Prophet and he will give him the message. And as Ibn Taymiyyah mentions, and Ibn Jama'ah, and Suyuti, and others, that the one that the Qur'an had is this one. The Qur'an was only this one. The fourth one. Are we all together, brothers? The Qur'an, مَا يَكُونُ بِوَاسِطَةِ أَمِينِ السَّمَاءِ. The Qur'an is the fifth one. Our Qur'an is one, this one. The other religions, they had the other wasa'it, the other means. Are we all together? The Qur'an came down unto the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the revelation of the Qur'an came down, بِوَاسِطَةِ أَمِينِ السَّمَاءِ. What's the evidence for that? Allah said, وَإِنَّهُ لَتَنْزِيلُ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ نَزَلَ بِهِ الرُّوحُ الْأَمِينَ عَلَى قَلْبِكَ لِتَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُنْذِرِينَ بِلِسَانٍ عَرَبِيٍ مُبِينٍ. That the Qur'an was sent down through Jibreel. Crystal clear? Are we all together? There are disputes amongst the scholars. Each point can be responded to, but we don't want to go into that. The second one is مَا يَكُونُ إِلْحَامًا. The Prophet will be inspired to do something. He will be what? He will be inspired to what? To do something. This is a revelation. مَا يَكُونُ مُكَالَمَةٌ بَيْنَ الْعَبْدِ وَالرَّبِّ. The slave talking to Allah, dialogue between prophets. The Prophet, sorry, and Allah Azza wa Jalla. Like Nabiullah Musa. Allah said, what did Allah say in the Quran? وَكَلَّمَ اللَّهُ مُوسَى تَكْلِيمًا. All of this four are all found in the Surah Shura. All four, Ayah 51. Ayah 51, Surah Shura, Allah mentions these four types. Let's go over it. Al-Imam al-Baghawi, let me bring his kalam. And go to Tafsir al-Baghawi. He brings all four out of this. He says, وَمَا كَانَ لِبَشَرٍ أَن يُكَلِّمَهُ اللَّهُ إِلَّا وَحْيًا. The first one is what? What was the first one I mentioned? Yeah? What was the first one from before? Dream. وَمَا كَانَ لِبَشَرٍ أَن يُكَلِّمَهُ اللَّهُ إِلَّا وَحْيًا. Baghawi said, that's number one and number two. The first part of the ayah is long, we're going to read it all. The first part is, وَمَا كَانَ لِبَشَرٍ أَن يُكَلِّمَهُ اللَّهُ إِلَّا وَحْيًا. He said, it's manam and it's also ilham. These two are the first part of the ayah. These two are what? مَا كَانَ لِبَشَرٍ أَن يُكَلِّمَهُ اللَّهُ إِلَّا وَحْيًا. That's the first part. Are we all together? أو من وراء حجاب means what? ما يكون مكالمة بين العبد والرب, he says. Allah is on this person just talking. That's the second one. It is أو من وراء حجاب. أو من وراء حجاب. That's the It's the third one, right? And the fourth one is أو يرسل رسولا أو يرسل رسولا. You see how the order four in one ayah? So the whole ayah, that one ayah, sorry, ayah 51 in Surah Ash-Shura, it tells you the four types in there. Who extracted it? Write the name down. It's important. Al-Imam. Al-Imam al-Baghawi extracted it. But all those four are in that one ayah. Does that make sense, brothers? Am I making sense? Yeah? So we mentioned, which one is the Quran? Yeah? The Quran is Jibreel. We mentioned that. Allah mentioned in many places, وَإِنَّا لَتَنْزِيلَ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ نَزَلَ بِهِ الرُّوحِ الْأَمِينَ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ. In another ayah, Allah says, قُلْ نَزَّلَهُ رُوحُ الْقُدُسِ. The Quran came from Jibreel. Beautiful. Now, I want to talk about something important, which is who gave it to Nabiullah Muhammad, the Quran, who brought it to him? I just mentioned who? Jibreel, where did he take it from? This is also spoken about when revelation is spoken about. Jibreel gave it to Nabiullah Muhammad, sah. Lakin where did Jibreel get it from? Yeah? There are two madhabs in this issue. I want you to take this down. Can I rub this off? There is two madhabs in this issue. Okay? There are what? Two madhabs. The first madhab, they say Jibreel took it from what? Lawh al-Mahfuz. And that is the kalam of Ahlul Bidah, the speech of the innovators, not the speech of Ahlul Sunnah. That he took it from Lawh al-Mahfuz, meaning Jibreel read Lawh al-Mahfuz and then he came to Nabiullah Muhammad and he gave it to him. This is not the mu'taqad of Ahlul Sunnah. Are you with me? Does that make sense? They say that Jibreel went to Lawh al-Mahfuz, he read the Lawh al-Mahfuz, and then he came to Nabiullah Muhammad and he gave the Quran to him. This is not what Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah believe. So what is it that they believe? They believe Talaqahu Jibreel, Jibra'il, both ways it can be said. Talaqahu Jibreel. Jibreel, he took it, sama'an min Allah, he heard it from Allah. Jibreel heard it from Allah. Jibreel heard Allah, sawtan, the sound, and he heard the huruf, the wordings, the alfaz. Are we all together, brothers? Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah believe, he heard it, Jibreel, from Allah Azza wa Jalla, and he gave it to Nabiullah Muhammad as well. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he took it from who? Jibreel. Does that make sense? So if you say, reason why, because they don't want to accept that Allah speaks. Are we all together? So this madhab is not a madhab which is madhab Ahlul Sunnah. This is the madhab we believe, which is that Jibreel took it from who? Question. Jibreel, when he came to, how did do I want to speak about that now? Okay, Jibreel used to come in two forms. Take this note this down as well. Jibreel used to come into what? Two forms. What are the two forms that he used to come in? He used to come in the form of himself. And the second one is that he used to come in the form of a human. The form of an angel, he will come when he brings the Quran. And he will never come in the form of a human. Note this down. It's important information. Jibreel, when he would come to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to bring the Quran, it was in his form. Are we all together, brothers? If Jibreel came, he would come in what? In his form. And he wouldn't come what? And he wouldn't come as a? He wouldn't come as a Bashar. Because if he did, Allah said in the Quran that the Quraysh and the disbelievers, what did they used to say? إِنَّمَا يُعَلِّمُهُ بَشَرٌ. Human is teaching him this. They used to accuse the Prophet ﷺ of taking this knowledge from a human. And Allah said, a human did not teach him this. So Jibreel did not come in the form of a human. Are we all together, brothers? Does that make sense? لكن he would, if he was bringing knowledge of the hadith and the sunnah, yes. Because of the famous hadith, بَيْنَمَا نَحْنُ جُلُوسٌ عِنْدَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ ذات يوم اطلع علينا رجل شديد بياض الثياب شديد سواد الشعر لا يرى عليه أثر السفر ولا يعرفه منا أحد حتى جلس إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فأسند ركبتي إلى ركبتي ووضع كفي على فخذي وقال يا محمد أخبرني عن الإسلام. وفهم وثي النس when he came. And when he would come in the form of a human, he would come in one of two forms. Either a Bedouin, or he would come in the form of the companion, Dihyatul Kilbi. Are we all together? So Jibreel would come to in his actual form when he was bringing the Quran as an angel. Pay attention to that, because he can't come in a human's form. If he did, then he would go against the ayah, إِنَّمَا يُعَلِّمُهُ بَشَرٌ. A human is teaching him this, and the human was not teaching him this. Does that make sense? And that is min bab al-takreem, to honor the Quran. The Jibreel come in his actual form. The veneration and the glorification of the Quran. But if he was to come with other revelation other than the Quran, which is the sunnah of revelation, right? Yeah? Is the sunnah not revelation? وَمَا يَنْتِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحِيُّ يُوحَىٰ. حافظ الحكم, what does he say? فَالسُنَّةُ النَّبِيِّ وَحْيٌ ثَانٍ عَلَيْهِمَا قَدْ أُطْلِقَ الْوَحْيَانِ وَإِنَّمَا طَرِيقُهَا الرِّوَايَةِ فَافْتَقَرَ الرَّاوِي إِلَى الدِّرَايَةِ. The sunnah is a what? فَالسُنَّةُ النَّبِيِّ وَحْيٌ ثَانٍ. The sunnah is another revelation. But when he came with the sunnah, Jibreel, he would come in the form of a human. Okay, he would come in the form of a human. Sometimes he would come as a Bedouin, an Arabi. Or he would come in the form of the companion Dihyatul Kalbi. Dihya. And if you go to Sir Alam al-Nubala by Imam al-Zahabi, he mentions that Dihya, the reason why Jibreel used to come into his form, because he was a very handsome man. Two companions were the two most handsome companions of the Prophet ﷺ. The first one is Dihya, and the second is Jarir ibn Abdullah al-Bajri. Who? Jarir ibn Abdullah al-Bajri. Who? Jarir ibn Abdullah. Ibn Jarir, he compares between who's handsome, more handsome. He talks about the narrations of the Aqwal. Yeah, Zahabi talks about it. Read it, inshallah ta'ala. Okay. How was the revelation when he came down to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? How was his situation? We're all together. This is the last point that we want to speak about, inshallah ta'ala. Bi-idhnillahi al-kareem. Which is, how was the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when the revelation will come down on him? There's a hadith that summarizes how the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was when the revelation will come down on him. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she said, أن الحارث ابن هشام, حارث ابن هشام, he came to the Messenger. حارث ابن هشام, he came to the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. And then he said to him, كيف يأتيك الوحي. So this is how. How did the revelation used to come to you? How? So he asked the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, أحيانا يأتيني في مثل صلصلة الجرس. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, that the revelation will come down to me sometimes as a ringing of a bell. So the first one the Prophet ﷺ mentioned was, it will come to me مثل صلصلة الجرس. Sometimes it comes to me like the ringing of a bell. The Prophet said, وهو أشده علي. The one that was the hardest on me was this one. So let's stand over this one. That's the first one. حالة الأولى, the first situation in which the revelation used to come down on the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم is what? Yeah? The first situation, حالة الأولى, it was what? The first situation? مثل صلصلة الجرس. It was like a ringing. And the Prophet ﷺ, he said, this was the hardest one for me. It's like a bell, noise, big noise would be made. And Imam Suyuti mentions, the reason this noise would be made, so the Prophet ﷺ can be awake, fully focused. This one was the one that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if he would be on his riding beast, as Imam Ahmad said in his narration, that if the Prophet was on his riding beast, even the riding beast would be moved by the when it came down on him like this. The neck of the animal would be pulled, it would be moving from the bottom. The animal, the riding beast, the camel, or the horse, whatever he was on, the animal would shake from the beneath its throat. Zayd ibn Thabit, he said, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, that if this type of revelation came down on the Prophet and he was sleeping on my thigh, his head, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, would become so heavy that it felt like my legs was breaking, that I could never walk on my legs ever again. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she said that if it was a cold day, he would sweat from this one. Excessively, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the first one is, مثل صلصلة الجرس. It's a very high noise. In another wording, it mentions the hadith of Umar radiallahu anhu, it was dawi ka dawi al-nahl. It wasn't a bell. It was like the noise that the bees make. What's that called? The buzzing, how is it humming? We use buzzing, less buzzing sounds better. So the buzzing of the bee, it was that noise, but it was very strong. This was the harshest one for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Are we all together? The second situation was, in which the hadith mentions, is وَأَحْيَانًا يَتَمَثَّلُ الْمَلَكُ مَلَكُ. Sometimes the angel will come to me in the form of a what? He will come to me in the form of a human being. He will come to me in the form of a human being. فَيُكَلِّمُنِي, he will speak to me. فَأَعِي مَا أَقُولُ, and I will understand what he was saying to me. And this we mentioned already, it's not referring to the Quran. This is not referring to the This revelation is not referring to the Quran. Because the Quran, he will come to him ala malakiyatihi, as an angel, not as a human being. I think we'll stop there, inshallah ta'ala. I'll take questions and answers, bi'idhnillah al-kareem. We'll leave the shubhas for next lesson, bi'idhnillah al-kareem. Any questions that anyone may have, fadl. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what did I say? The Quran, it came down from who? Jibreel. But did every single time Jibreel come to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? I think was the Quranic revelation of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on Jibreel, was it every single time Jibreel came to him? The scholars, they said la. Jibreel will come once a year to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he came to preparing the Quran with him. Are we all together, brothers? Are we all together? Once, which was Ramadan. And he said the last day the Prophet was passing away, how many times did he come to him? Huh? Twice he came to him. Ibn al-Qayyim said that when the Prophet said, Ra'aytu Jibreel, I saw Jibreel, وَعَلَيْهِ سِتُمِئَةَ جَرَاحٍ, and he had 600 wings. Each wing, one of his wings, it can block off the whole horizon. Ibn al-Qayyim said that he did see Jibreel after that. That doesn't eliminate that he saw Jibreel after it. Are we all together? That was when he saw it, he said, I saw it. Jibreel came to him after that. Because revelation was still coming down on him. He mentions that in his kitab, Al-Bada'i Al-Fawa'id, rahimahullah ta'ala. Which one? And the last is in Isra al-Mi'raj. Did it come down on Isra al-Mi'raj, the two last ayahs? No, that's what, in the narration, does it state that he took it from Allah directly? So we know the Prophet ﷺ, the night of Isra al-Mi'raj, he took rulings from Allah Azza wa Jal. And Allah told him the Salah and Ahkam, other rulings. But did he take Quran of the night of Isra al-Mi'raj? Was it a revelation that came down on him? None of the narrations mention that. None of the narrations mention that. Was to just bring the ayah Quran. The thing is, I haven't looked, I can't remember the narration's authenticity, that's why I don't remember if it's authentic or not. Like, inshallah ta'ala, look into the last ayat of Surah Al-Baqarah. La shaka Ibn Kathir will bring it in his tafsir. So we'll verify that, inshallah. Faddala. So the issue of qira'at, we're coming to it, inshallah ta'ala. It's one of the things that we're going to speak about in great details, especially when we talk about the qira'at and the ahruf al-sab'ah. What is the difference? And how is it? And how does it work? Because it's slightly confusing if we talk about the qira'at and the ahruf al-sab'ah. Like, in all of this came down from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every single one of it came down from Allah azza wa jalla. تفضل ها so see the Quran, The Prophet ﷺ was told to read the Mu'awwadhatayn when he had Ayn done to him. But he came down before that. So the ayat, some of the Qusur, they didn't just come down once, they came twice. So he came down twice. Second thing is, sometimes the Prophet ﷺ will receive a revelation sent to him and he will be told to use that revelation for something. Like the Mu'awwadhatayn. The Mu'awwadhatayn, they came down before, and when the Prophet ﷺ was, the magic was done to him, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Allah instructed him to read it. But it wasn't that it came down at that particular moment. No. The Quran, Jibreel heard it from Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah says in the Quran, Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr. In another ayah, Allah says, Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil mubaraka. Inna kunna munzilin. The Quran, we know it all came down once. The whole Quran. But where did it come down on? Sama'i dunya. And from there it came down munajjaman. Munajjaman means what? Bit by bit. Lakin Jibreel heard it all from Allah Azza wa Jal. And then he was then instructed each verse, because Allah knows the incident and the things that are going to take place, each part Allah was commanding him, that part, take it down now. Are you with me, brothers? And so each verse and each was coming down on that particular instant. But prior to that, Jibreel heard it all from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to convey it to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But it was all placed in Sama'i Dunya, and it was coming down from there munajjaman, bit by bit. That's the only way to reconcile between the aqwal of the Ahlul Ilm. And I on my channel, I spoke about this in more details when I spoke about the tafsir of the Surah Laylat al-Qadr. The aqwal of Ibn Abbas and the others who differed with him. Fadal. Ramadan, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to finish the Quran with Jibreel. They used to revise. And that was once a year, the revision. And the last year that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was dying, Jibreel came and he finished the Quran this time with him twice, not once. How many times did he finish it this time? They finished it twice. And scholars, they took from this, if the person grows old in age, and they realize that they're getting closer to their grave, they should multiply their righteous deeds. Are you with me? If you feel that you've grown old and now you've aged and you're more closer to your date of leaving this world, you should multiply your righteous deeds. Because the Prophet ﷺ, that year, he was going to depart from the world. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he increased in his recitation of the Quran. In that Ramadan. Some people, when they become old in age, they become more businessmen. And they start liking dunya more and start becoming investing in this and that. The older you get, the more you should connect yourself to the masjid. The more you should start staying in the masjid. And knowing that the time is going to finish. There are scholars who hold that opinion. Some scholars who hold that the revelation is not restricted to Jibreel. But each point that they brought and the discussion pertaining to that, we've left it for some other time. Because we just wanted your overview. But that's why I said the other day, if you guys can read the Kitab al-Itqan fi Ulum al-Qur'an, it's very important. Some things I just mentioned, I go over it quickly, you can go and research even more. And you might even differ with me. After your research, you might think that that view that I've took is not strong. This is the beauty. But you have to do your research and read the Kitab al-Itqan fi Ulum al-Qur'an by Suyuti and other books that are written in the science of the Qur'an. Are you with me, brothers? Fadal. No, the Qur'an, the sequence, the ayat are what the Prophet ﷺ set it as. Like in the surah, the companions did it. That's what they said. Like the surah of the Qur'an, the companions are the ones who ordered it like this. This is the call of the Jumhur. Like in the ayat and the surahs that it's in, the Prophet ﷺ did that. He commanded it. He would say to the companion, take this ayah and place it in surah, kada wa kada. And it would be placed. Nope. The Quran surah, so اقرأ بسم ربك الذي came down, the first six came down, and then Surah Al-Mudathir came down. So it would mean an ayah from this would come, an ayah from the Prophet would command the companions, he would say, take this verse and place it in that surah. Take that verse and place it into the surah. He read it on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Like in the surah, the scholars, these are masail which are, the khilaf is too much. I'm just trying to mean the, but that's why it's good to read the Kitab al-Itqan. Suyuti brings all the views, he brings the evidences, and he did, was the Kitab al-Itqan was sent out, right, to everybody? Was it sent out via email? Huh? It was sent via email to everyone? Huh? People didn't receive it via email. So if it could be sent to them via email, it will help them a lot. Should we conclude there, inshallah ta'ala? Fadallah, yeah. How do we reconcile the first lecture we learned that, you know, the understanding of the Quran is with the Sahara? And how do we reconcile, or do we take into consideration that Ilham al-Fitri in understanding the Quran and Sunnah, or we don't take Ilham al-Fitri, or it's just the understanding on the Quran? So the Ilham al-Fitri, can that be made into a legislation? No, abadan, it can't be. It's not a legislation. Ilham, what takes more precedence over that is what is aql, logic, and the person's mindset. All of those, they don't have a place in legislation. The path to Allah and what pleases Allah and what Allah loves, that cannot be known by a person's innate ability. Or even dreams. Somebody might say, I saw the Prophet in my dream. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told me that you don't have to pray salah anymore. He said it to me, wallahi. Are you with me? What you saw in your dream, whatever command he gave you or they gave you, will not stop the hukum of Allah that's upon you. Whatever it may be. We'll conclude there, inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.